Hey everybody, John Abigail here. Hello and good afternoon greetings from Mount Crawford, Virginia. The local time here is 4:44. Today is May 2nd, 2020. Temperature here is 72 degrees. We are here to pick up a load going to back to Wisconsin. Our appointment here is supposedly at 5 p.m. So we're right on time. And I think I see an opening parking spot there. Been assigned to door 209, which is right in front of us. Well, next to the Freightliner. Let's go this way. Yeah. ahead. Yes, sir. Catch you later. All right, everybody, we are loaded. I'm expecting a phone call from Long Haul Larry, so I'm a little bit in anticipation. right, the local time here, by the way, is 5 p.m. Temperature is 74 degrees. Just occurred to me while I was lining up to get my paperwork, and the thought was, what if this disease is really as deadly as they say it is? And worse, what if they will not be able to find a cure for, let's just say, a year, 2 years, 10 years, or never? How many of you have ever thought about that? I'd like to hear your thoughts about that. What do you think the world will do? I think everybody will be forced to go back to work. And I think people are gonna die, they're gonna die. Until the whole world develops an antibody or immunity to this thing, right? Isn't that the way it goes? Life, everything equalizes at the end, right? I mean, look at the economy. If something bad happens, the economy always finds a way to fix itself. But I'm curious to what you think. What would happen if they can't find a cure with this? Or it may not take, it may take a while before they can find a cure. What do you think the world will do? What do you think the world will look like? And for example, would that be an excuse for people not to go back to work? There's a distinct possibility at that issue. Look at people that are, some people would rather be on welfare than go to work. Now with this disease around, they can always say, you know what? I'm too scared to go to work. Let me know what you think. It'd be interesting. Hey, welcome to Raphine, Virginia. The local time here is 6:34. Temperature 72 degrees. I gotta get fuel and reefer fuel. And I gotta clean this windshield. Holy smokies. The bugs are just smeared all over the windshield. It's got that film on it. And I tried cleaning it with my windshield washer fluid. Nope, it ain't gonna do it. So we're gonna have to do it the old-fashioned way. We don't need it. Tractor. Hell yeah, sure. Okay, 2, 8, 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oop, sorry. Too much numbers. I do on touching things? Don't worry, everything will kill you. Everything will kill you eventually. Trucking.
17 years.
You like it?
Yep.
Seventeen years. Woo. Yeah. La da 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 da.
Professional drivers, don't forget to use 5 forward start at landings.
The sun, we let it up, blah 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 blah. Blah 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 da 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 da. I almost forgot to get something. Whew. Forgot to get the GoPros. Oh, yeah. understand why we only have 89 gallons in there. You gotta have more than that. Blah 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 blah. Pump 18. Pump 18. Yeah, 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 yeah. See, I knew we were missing a couple of gallons. So I take it that was only one side of the tank. Good beans. Thank you. You're welcome. Apple Pay. Hello, Your Grace. You're thirsty again. Jiminy Crickets, Your Grace. What do you do with all that fuel? Big difference from 189, right? I just lost $1.64. Actually, I lost like $3 because I'm up to four cents per penny. No, 4 cents per gallon. The reward that I would have been taking right now, because I have been. That just ruined my day. Peace.